Well, Sam Longmore was just 20 years old and living a big, busy life when she was involved in two car accidents on the same day. The tragedy left her in a wheelchair, paralysed one side and struggling to cope. But a creative outlet proved a lifesaver for her, and Sam joins us now. Sam, it's so good to have you this morning. Can you tell us about the days leading up to that accident back in 2013, wasn't it?
Yeah, 2013. So it would have been about 3 days and I hadn't had any sleep. So I was working two jobs at the time. One of those jobs was on a farm, and the other one of those was Thursday, Friday, Saturday night at a nightclub. So no sleep.
That's wow.
Jeez. Yes.
But you didn't just have one accident that morning. You had two, huh?
I do.
So what happened? What happened in the first one?
Well, I fell asleep and crashed my car.
Right.
On my way home from work on the Barton Highway, so just outside of Canberra in New South Wales. And then the same thing happened in the ambulance on the way back to the hospital, but in the ACT on the same stretch of road, so within about 45 minutes of each other.
Wow. So on the way to the hospital to be treated for your injuries, it happens again.
Yeah. Yeah.
How badly injured were you the second time?
Look, I guess that's been the hardest thing over the last 7 years is, I guess, determining that. At the end of the day, I'll always take some responsibility for the whole lot. I should have had some sleep. At the end of the day, this is my life now, so that doesn't really matter.
Must be so frustrating after going from this big, busy life to having to start again and find your new place in the world. Yeah. Knitting has been a really big part of that, hasn't it?
Yeah, strangely enough.
How did you pick that up? You don't strike me as a knitter.
No, I'm not. I'm not a knitter. I had always loved being in the agricultural industry. I worked a lot in the shearing sheds and obviously on the farm beforehand. And yeah, I've always been a creative too, but never a knitter. Mm-hmm. I kind of just jammed the two of them together and off I went.
How do you knit with one side of your body
paralyzed? With this bad boy.
What is that?
This is just a piece of dowel.
Did you come up with this yourself?
Yeah. So the first time I started knitting, I used a curtain rod, actually. So a lot of people would have seen the arm knitting, so on and off both your arms, or knitting with really large knitting needles, I guess. Whereas I just use just the one. Pop it under my leg, up onto my other one, and pop my wool on the ground, and off we go.
That's awesome.
Show us how it's done.
Okay, I'll give you a bit of a run through.
So was someone else in your family into all this, or is this something you kind of just went, what can I do now?
What can I do to be a part of the community again? Back into the agricultural community, loved wool, and here we are.
I think it's fantastic. You've been teaching other people in your workshops as well, which I think is fantastic.
Yeah. So in my workshops, I teach people how to make a blanket. I also teach a little bit of resilience, just general conversation, because at the end of the day, within 4 hours, you can make a blanket. And people feel, I don't know, full. They feel like they've accomplished something. And that was what I needed when I first started knitting, to feel full. Again, we'd have a wine or a cuppa and have a bit of a laugh, and it just brings people together, and I love that too. Yeah. So that's two rows there.
That's fascinating.
Yeah.
And it's more than just the blanket you take away, isn't it? It's that connection and being part of a group and doing something.
And just being able to have conversation, I think, you know, as good as social media is, being able to come together and have a conversation and connect, this is how I'm here today. So, due to my workshop.
That's incredible. What sort of people are taking your workshops?
What was that, sorry?
What sort of people are taking your workshops?
Everyone.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Kids, so not women, just people, not just people who've been injured, that type of thing?
No.
And do you find that it is a bit frustrating to get the hang of it at first and people are probably...
I did, yes. I found it very frustrating, one, to teach myself, but more frustrating to teach others. I didn't respect teachers as much as I do now. Teaching adults, we think we know everything. We don't. And that was very, very clear. So I've had to, I guess, take on almost a childlike teaching method. You know, we come out and we become an aeroplane, you know, and then we do these Pac-Man things and a few bits and pieces, have a bit of fun. And that's what helps people learn. But being able to laugh, being able to be, you know, the country chick that I am, easygoing, without it feeling like you're sitting in a classroom,
I'd say you're inspirational, but you hate being called that.
I do. I don't feel like that. I'm just your average Joe Blow. Yeah. It just so happens to live on a farm and I knit things with one hand.
And you just happen to be very inspirational, so...
Thanks. I mean,
we'll keep banging on about it because it's very important and you need to know that whether you feel that way or not, you give inspiration to other people.
Yeah.
So, you know, well done.
Well, thanks,
it's
done.
Great to speak to you, and this is superb. You can check out Sam's beautiful knits online and on Instagram and online. Look for Oh Bulldust.
Is that what you say every time you drop a stitch?
Something like that.
Fantastic. Thanks for your time today. It was a pleasure.
Thanks, lovely.